Now we have Joy News TV's Roland Walker for more on this. Good afternoon, or good evening. Thanks for joining us, Roland. Now, the protest, the vigil in Ghana on Saturday were meant to be peaceful. So tell us, why do the police and the military feel the need to intervene?
Well, according to the Public Order Act that we have in the Republic of Ghana, anybody or individual or group that wanted to organize any sort of protest or public event at all would need to give the police 5 to 6 clear day notice. And indeed, the group that was solidarizing with the Black Lives Matter that is led by one Mr. Emesley Abua had done that application. They had been given that permission according to what he showed the media to be able to convene that event. And it was a vigil that was convened on Saturday night. So it's not the first time he is organizing an event at all. And that's a result of that he's very used to organizing such public events. And he was surprised himself because if you look at the event, he did not just appear on his own. He also had other people of African descent, especially Black Americans who call themselves the diasporans, who had settled here in Ghana for a number of years. Some of them have citizenship. Some of them have also adopted citizenship or advanced. And it was something that was not expected, according to him. And so he was just picked up by the security apparatus.
The world is still coping with the pandemic, and now these protests against racism are growing global. Is police brutality as real in Ghana to warrant a protest?
Police brutality is not rampant in Ghana. Of course, we tend to see year-on-year sporadic events of the police either manhandling people. Sometimes, even right here at Joy News, we've had a number of reports compiled by a number of our correspondents and reporters about police either indiscriminately shooting or wrongly just shooting people in the line of duty. And it's not like you find in situations elsewhere, especially in America or even in the United Kingdom, as you find them. But once in a while, you tend to have some of these events that have been documented. You will remember that the last year we had the national security apparatus during a by-election for which subsequently a commission was set up. A commission of inquiry was set up by the president to investigate an incident in which we have or we had a number of security personnel of the national apparatus in court for which this commission, based on its findings, said the personnel who were arrogated that power or that duty to come to the by-election event did not have the right competence in training, the right sort of training also to disperse crowd, to manage an event or event in any way, and so went beyond bounds and flouted the right of normal citizens of our country. That received wide condemnation, not only in Ghana, but also elsewhere across the continent and the world. And so you will find that we have various personnel within the services, especially within the police, who once in a while will brutalize or molest citizens. And these have been brought to the attention of the police hierarchy. What they have done and promised the Ghanaian public is that something will be done about it. But usually it is just a matter thrown to the door.
Now, speaking of the pandemic, Roland, Ghana, like most of other African countries, has eased lockdown restrictions. What sort of measures exist now to help curb the spread of the coronavirus?
I have to again point out vividly that currently our case count, if you take a look at the number of cases we have so far, is giving us the indication of where the direction has been. But let me just first make the statement. In early March, around March 11, March 12, there was the lockdown. It went for about 3 weeks. And then the president of the republic decided to lift the lockdown, but still maintained a restriction. And this restriction was legalized. It's a law which was approved by the Parliament of the Republic of Ghana. Now, it's called these were contained in the Restrictions Act that ensured that people were not given the opportunity to move about freely, not to convene public events. It was limited to about 25 people, and until the last week was 25, and now has been taken to 50 and subsequently 100 as it is. These measures were done, including closing borders, making sure that public events were also restricted to a certain number of people, so that we will be in a position to restrict the movement of citizens and people. Because the World Health Organization has indicated that it is when people move that results in a number of the infections as we see. Now we have the infections going into the community. And the case count currently, that is the formal case on the website of the Ghana Health Service, that is the official confirmed cases, are 9,910. Now this is the case count from start to date. So it's an up-to-date case. However, we say that we've had a number of recoveries, 3,645 and 48 dead. So the active cases currently in Ghana, in communities, especially in Accra, for which we have about 6,400 in excess of them, are just around 6,217. Of course, we've had cases in other regions like the Ashanti region, Western region. So I would say that the measures internationally have been said to be bold. They've restricted people. They've ensured that PPEs have been distributed to various health centers, frontline health workers. They've also encouraged people, ordinary Ghanaians on the streets of our republic, to put on masks. And then even we've moved to the next step of saying that citizens need to put on the mask. So there's some form of enforceability to the directive in a way, even though it's not in the law.
Joy TV correspondent Roland Walker, thanks for speaking with us on the program.